Okay, for the presentation, we will follow this outline. I will not emphasize on it. I don't like too much these pictures. I don't know where my colleague brings them, but it's to show us the context of cholera in many countries in Africa. And we can also state that the majority of cholera burden worldwide occur in South African countries. You can see it on this map. In Africa, we used to conduct the epidemic intelligence intervention through the daily rumor monitoring. And what we see in 2018 is that we have an average of 3 public health events per week. And more than 88% of these events are due to infectious disease outbreak. Of them, 12% were due to cholera. It is a daily activity implemented in the regional office. And from 2006 to 2016, we have a total of around 800,000 cases and around 80,000 deaths in Africa, reported from 17 countries. In 2017 alone, we had around 150,000 suspected cases, with around 3,200 deaths. And 90% of the cases were reported from 5 countries. We know them. Here we can see all these 5 countries and the burden of the cholera in these countries. But we want here to highlight that in South Sudan, we are facing a very encouraging trend. As stated by Dominique this morning, the last reported case was in week 46 of 2017, and so far we are facing 0 cases in this country. In 2018, we reported 112,000 deaths and around 2,350 deaths in the country from 15 countries. Around 3/3 of these cases were reported from sea-bordering countries. They are the DRC, Nigeria, Niger, Kenya, Zimbabwe, and Tanzania. We faced cross-border transmission, who was documented mainly from Nigeria to some neighboring countries. And the outbreak was controlled in 6 countries out of 15 this year. We have here the presentation of this outbreak regarding the ERF, the outbreak graded as grade 2. We have 2 countries. 7 countries were ungraded, and 6 countries were graded grade 1 of ERF. Here also, we can see the situation in Zimbabwe as of week 49 of 2016. Our colleague has already presented the situation. The context is also that in Africa, the member state has endorsed a regional framework for the cholera elimination. The roadmap was endorsed in Dakar in last August, and there is a regional committee executive summary on the commitment of these countries. So in Africa now, all the countries are committed politically to the elimination of cholera. But we know that to reach this elimination, we need to have some pillars in place. And between these pillars, we have the surveillance. And now we will go to what we are expecting from the countries. The roadmap wants to shift from the emergency response to the prevention and control through long-term and sustainable WASH and other intervention at country level. It's just a reminder, if I can say like that. Now, how cholera is reported at national level in African region? The guiding strategy for the surveillance in the continent is the integrated disease surveillance and response. This strategy defines and classifies disease by groups, and we have the epidemic prone disease, of which cholera is the first one listed in the region. The IDSR defines some core functions, starting by the detection, to the report, to the analysis, the investigation, the response, and what we call feedback, the communication. There are also provisions on resources, what we need to have as human resources, and what are the supportive functions such as training that need to be implemented. And the strategy is endorsed by 40 countries in the continent. And the IDSR is completed during outbreak and humanitarian situation by other ad hoc strategies, namely the EWARS, the EWARN. Data are being managed through different forms, including Excel sheets and the DHIS2. In each country, there is a scheduled reporting flow and format. We can see that there are a lot of variation. Nigeria was not there. If not, we will witness this variation. Paper-based reporting is still ongoing in some parts of countries in Africa, and this can be a factor for the delay in the reporting. Electronic surveillance is a growing available way of notification in many countries. We see the example of South Sudan. There is also a good experience in Madagascar and other countries where there are some electronic platform to have the information in real time from the field. The DHIS2 is being used as data managed database, and the information is exported to Excel sheet and shared with over level. So there are a level of compilation also. Data are compiled by level, district, region prior to sharing to the national level, where the final compilation is performed before sharing with AFRO. Normally, data on cholera surveillance should be shared to AFRO, normally on weekly disease. But what are we facing? It is planned that IDSR routine data be shared weekly, no later than the Thursday of the following weeks. And during outbreak, this data can be shared daily or weekly based on what we decide. But we need to emphasize that the data shared includes confirmed and suspected cases, and also other laboratory information, such as the type of virus and so on. But a large proportion of countries are sharing data on Excel format. You can see that we have a lot of red places. These are the countries who are not reporting data to AFRO. You can see that If we maintain this trend, it will be difficult to follow the trend of cholera in the region, and this can plague the global effort to the elimination of cholera. In yellow is the country reporting, but without a good promptness. And when you have a green, yes, we have good promptness and completeness of data. At Afro level, what do we do with the data we have? Based on the finding during interaction with countries on the management of outbreak and IDSR data, we develop a cholera toolkit. It's a platform developed to input line lists and to make analysis at regional level and share with country. The toolkit is also developed for other diseases such as Lassa fever, yellow fever, and so on. And we have five analyses who are being conducted, place, time, and so on. Afro is also developing now what we call a data warehouse and dashboard for cholera. The objective is to have a full range of cholera-related information through production of visualizable dashboards to support monitoring of response. And you will have this the TOR of this warehouse on the sheet who will be shared with you in the package you will receive. It is here. We don't have enough time. You will have it. The objective is in real time to follow up the cholera trend in country based on the information shared by this country. We have here two examples of what is being done for Kenya and for Nigeria. But we are still facing some challenges. The first one is the low timeliness and completeness. Only 10 countries reported consistently IDSR data since the beginning of this year. And we have 28 countries who don't report data since the beginning of the year. The quality of data is also challenging. There are still delays in the outbreak detection, and the ad hoc mechanism information are not shared with Afro. But our colleague from country can we will help us to know if the information collected through this mechanism are included in the data share with Afro. The data, IDSR data, do not include outbreak data. You will be surprised to have some countries facing cholera outbreak, but sharing IDSR with zero case of cholera is challenging. And I think that this challenge can plague our effort as state above. We are here having some way forward. I will emphasize on the need to strengthen capacity of national experts on IDSR and cholera surveillances, because in the country level, we are having now new team who are not familiar to IDSR. And there will also be a need to extend the rumor monitoring to all the countries. This will help to detect alerts on time and verify and know if we are facing cholera outbreak or not. Many thanks for your support.